God bless you. We are so excited to be coming your way again. Team Patterson with Keeping It Straight. I am your host, Apostle Dr. Barbara Patterson, along with my handsome husband,
Senior Pastor Lorenzo Patterson.
And we have an awesome topic. Again, we want to thank all of our listeners for just, you know, being a blessing, for just tuning and sharing the gospel as we share it. We have a wonderful topic tonight. And, you know, last week we finished our three-part series. We was talking about, you know, being under the influence of demonic spirits. And something happened this week, Pastor. I picked my grandkids up from school and they wanted to go by the park, I guess, to run some of that energy that they have on. And we were there, and my middle granddaughter, Kaylin, she's so funny. They call her Little Me. She decided that she wanted to, you know, get on the sliding board. I guess that's what they still call it, sliding board. Okay.
The high one.
Anyway, you have to go through the ropes to get to. She did okay till she got at the top. When she got at the top, she decided that she was afraid to come through the tunnel to slide down. So I'm looking at her, and everybody's like, Kaylin, you can do it. You know, come on down. You can do it. And I wasn't, I'm going to be real with you, I wasn't about to climb that those ropes to get her. So there was something that happened that day that really just blessed me. There was a young Caucasian girl there. She looked to be maybe about 13 years old, and she walked up to me. She said, Miss, do you mind if I go up and get her? And I said, no, sweetie, thank you. And so she went up and she got her and, you know, climbed up the ropes and got Kaylin. Kaylin was still afraid, but she talked her into putting her in her lap, and she slid through the tunnel and brought her to me. And God gave me something, Pastor. Mm. And I got something out of this, and I think I may have shared it earlier, but he told me, he said that, you know, if we could just see each other through the eyes of children. Or just see, you know, the way she saw. She did not look at Kaylin as being a African-American,
right,
black African-American. She saw her as just being a child in need, a person in need. And we could just see the world that way. We could just see each other that way. I'm telling you this, we would be in a better place. So tonight we're talking about the love of the brethren. And our key scripture is coming from 1 John, the 3rd chapter. Mm. And we are going to begin at the 11th verse. And I'm coming from the NIV version. It said, for this is the message you heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. Do not be like Cain, who belonged to the evil one and murdered his brother. And why did he murder him? Because his own actions were evil. Oh my God. His own actions were evil, and his brothers were righteous. All right. If the world hates you, we know that we have passed from death to life. That's our key verse. Because we love each other. Anyone who does not love remains in death. In other words, we have to die. We have to die to our old ways.
That's
we have
right.
to die to our feelings. Okay.
Yes.
So I believe the writer John, to be one of the same one that wrote the Gospel of John, 2 John and 3 John. He wrote this letter to the church. He is writing, first of all, to believers on how they should be acting, Pastor, toward each other and to others outside of the faith. We're talking about the love for the brethren.
Amen.
He begins his message with, this is the message that you have heard from the beginning. In other words, you have heard this from the beginning. Jesus taught this from the beginning.
Amen.
And you say, what message? The message to love one another like Christ. Oh,
yes.
My God. Don't allow evil to be in your heart so bad and unchecked that you kill your brother just like Cain did with his brother Abel. Mm. How do we kill? How can we kill? We may not put a knife in each other's throat or right. strangle each other, but we can kill them yes. by our actions,
Amen.
By the way we talk at, or act toward one another.
That's right.
This baby, this child, when she saw my grandbaby up there, mm-hmm. she did not see a black American, African American.
Right.
She saw a person in need.
Right.
And she reached out
yes.
and did what she needed to do to help her come out of that situation.
Amen.
Evil in Cain's heart because of Abel's sacrifice was accepted by God. And Cain's sacrifice was not. Remember now, Cain had the same opportunity to get it right. Instead of just asking Abe, you know, what do I need to do? All right.
Amen.
Cain knew he offered God a blemished offering, and Abel did not. But Cain was still filled with anger that killed his brother. Now, we talked about that. We cannot allow anger to cause us to kill and hurt one another. All right.
Amen.
Don't be surprised that the world hates you. Yes, the world will hate us because of what we stand for.
That's right.
But we cannot hate the world. All right. Because if you are not careful, you will have the same kind of hatred in your heart.
That's right.
All right. The world is specific as to what hatred is, and they understand it. But we as Christians, we have to understand what real love is in our heart.
Amen.
All right. We have to understand, and I'm going to say this, and I'm going to let my pass it on to Pastor Patterson. During 2020, and I'm going to bring this out, we saw a lot of hatred. We saw a lot of hatred.
Yes.
And this is when the church should have really made a difference.
That's right.
Yes, there were events. There were things that happened that was not right. But God called us to continue to walk in love. All right. Our differences should not have caused us, mm-hmm. charged us to stop loving each other, Pastor.
That's right.
Go ahead on, Pastor.
Praise God. John writes that to love one another is an obligation one could do and should do.
That's right.
It is an act of loving the same way Christ modeled on the cross.
Mm-hmm.
Not one of us would say that Jesus did not go to the cross for those that hated, offended, or had private motives,
mm-hmm.
disagreed with him, twisted his words, just could not get along with him.
Uh-huh.
Praise God. But there was room at the cross for all of them.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what they said, no matter what they did to Christ, he allowed reconciliation to be there for each and every person.
Uh-huh.
Praise God. Cain lost his way as soon as he allowed evil in his heart and his self-righteousness to compromise what he knew what was right.
Uh-huh.
Praise God. His jealous heart was wrong, so wrong, acts followed out. Praise God. This is how we know that love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. And we ought to lay down our lives for our brother every day that we live.
Uh-huh.
If anyone has material possessions and sees his brother in need,
uh-huh.
but has not pity on him, how can the love of God be in that person?
Uh-huh.
Dear children, let us not love with words or tongue, but with actions in truth.
Uh-huh.
Praise God.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
we are to be loving our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Uh-huh.
There is a clear message, praise God, in warning the church that we must be loving to each other.
Mm-hmm.
Will we not agree on all things at all times? We won't. We won't all agree on everything that we do.
Mm-hmm.
How can you expect the church to be in unity on every issue when we cannot even agree on every issue in our own homes?
My God, that's
my
right.
My Lord. How can we have disagreements with solutions unless we acknowledge?
You got to acknowledge.
I'm going to say this again. How can we have disagreements with solutions unless we acknowledge that we are different people with different personalities? trying to find our way to serve God as the body of Christ.
My God. Amen. All right. Amen. Awesome. So what was said, there are absolutes, yes, in God's word.
Yes, it is.
And I'm not going to dispute that. I would not dispute that at all. No one is asking that the truths of God be violated.
That's right.
That's not what this is about. That the truth, the word will stand.
It's
amen.
Stand by.
But we must come. I'm going to say this. We must come to the table in love.
Yes.
If we are to see one another's hurts.
Amen.
If we are to see people's hearts change by God over issues that are keeping us divided. Didn't he say, come, let us reason together,
yes,
saith the Lord. All right. So the 13th verse says in that same passage, do not be surprised, my brother, if the world hates you. All right. So what does surprise mean in the Greek? Wonder. Don't marvel or be astonished. You're supposed to be hated.
That's right.
Because of who you stand for. We stand for the truth. We stand for the gospel of Jesus Christ. And Jesus also stood for the truth.
Yes, he
did.
Yes, he did.
But it never changed his heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know why I know it? Because when he went on that cross,
yes,
he went for the liars.
That's
he
right.
went for the backbiters.
There was room.
He even went, glory to God, for them that hollered, Hosanna, Hosanna, on Friday.
Amen.
Oh, my God. But maybe on Wednesday,
yes,
but crucify him on Friday.
That's right.
He hung there.
He hung
and
there.
You know what? Because of his love, he said what? Father, forgive them. For they know not what they do. So the world, we expect the world to react,
yes,
to things a little different than we do. All right. So the world is defined by John in chapter 2 as hostile to God.
Mm.
We expect the world to be hostile to God because they are people are being controlled by demonic influences.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean we have to continue to walk in love.
That's right.
We have to continue to walk in truth.
Amen.
And as I said earlier, we cannot allow our differences,
yes,
to cause us to separate.
To
dislike each other.
Amen.
We know that the world is hostile to the church.
Mm-hmm.
But should the world... oh, my God, let me get this right, because the enemy don't want me to get this right. We know that the world is hostile to the church,
mm-hmm,
but should the church be hostile to itself?
Come on now.
And not want to minister outside of the walls, all right?
Amen.
Or help a brother, a sister who has fallen.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to, as believers, reach out to a wounded family,
yes,
member.
Yes, yes.
Amen. To make sure that they are not left out on the battlefield.
That's right.
This is what this young girl did. She reached out to my granddaughter, mm-hmm, to make sure that she came down. Oh, my God. You know, God has a strange way of speaking to us.
Yes, he does.
There should not be wounded soldiers left to die on their own. In other words, what are you saying? We should be spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ,
amen,
through love like never before.
Yes.
This pandemic, amen, amen, it hurt a lot of people. A lot of people may have even turned their back on who Christ was because they didn't understand, amen, what was going on.
Right.
And so, Pastor, it was our job to continue to show love, to continue to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Oh, my God.
Amen.
If a Samaritan who hated a Jew, now, I want y'all to hear me,
mm-hmm,
could reach out. Y'all know the story of the Good Samaritan. Bandage and pay for the care for a Jew. How much?
Come on.
How much should believers help one another?
That's right.
Get to the finish line of life.
Mm.
Oh, my God, my God, my God. There is a complete, oh, my God.
Come on.
We have to understand that there could also be a complete sermon on its own just to teach us on how to love.
That's right.
My God, your sermon, your message every day should be about the love of Christ.
Yeah.
Loving one another. Oh, my God. Amen. So that is why the Samaritan woman was so surprised that Jesus would ask for a drink, not of his own cup. He asked her.
That's right.
Amen. For a drink.
That's right.
And she looked at him. I'm a Samaritan, you know. And you know, and I think what we see here, the thing, can anything good come through Samaria?
Yeah.
But Jesus reached beyond being a Jew. Come on now.
Right.
And he helped this woman.
Yes, he did.
Oh, my God. And listen, she became one of the first preachers of the gospel because she ran back and spread it, the good news of Jesus Christ.
Witness.
Come on, Pastor.
Praise God. The apostles were Jew of all Jews and were sent to get food in the abiding town because Jesus wanted time to talk with this girl alone. And he gave the apostle a teaching lesson when they returned and could not understand why he was talking to that Samaritan woman. John introduced us to something new here.
Come on,
God.
Pastor, come on.
We know that we have passed from death to life because of what Christ has done.
That's right.
Us.
Amen.
This is how God showed us his love among us. He sent his one and only son into the world that we might live through him.
Live through him.
Praise
come
God,
on now.
That we may live through him.
Uh-huh.
He first loved us, so we cannot get all high and mighty of how we came to Christ because Christ came to us first.
Yes.
We just responded to his love.
Yes, he came to us first.
That's right. He came to us first.
But we responded,
but we responded to
God's his love.
Love.
Amen. Come on now.
Praise God. The word of God said, no man cometh unless the Father, let the Spirit draw of him.
Uh-huh.
So we could not even come to Jesus unless his love drawed us first.
Uh-huh.
Praise
uh-huh.
God.
My God.
Because his love in us, we should love others.
That's right.
Does not mean we agree with everything others say or do.
That's right.
Praise God. Does not mean you allow your values torn down or change if they line up with God's word.
That's right.
The end result should always be reconciliation to God, not judgment.
And you know, we hear that a lot. You know, I'm not gonna take down. I know what I believe.
Right.
But we still have to show love.
We still have to
show love. You can bring truth through love.
That's right.
You can bring correction through love. Come on, Pastor.
I'm gonna say this. God breaks the barrel of tradition from what we used to. He did the same thing with Peter and Cornelius.
Mm-hmm.
Peter was so traditionalized, he could not go and touch bases with Cornelius because he said, touch not the unclean thing. They're not Jews.
Mm-hmm.
But God changed Peter's life.
Yes, he did.
He changed his heart, and he had to go minister to Cornelius.
That's right.
Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Whatever you do, whatever you say, reflects positively or negatively on whose name you care. We
All
carry
right.
the name of Jesus.
Who do we carry?
The name of Jesus.
Oh, my God. Come
we
on.
We are to be loving to the lost. Dear children, let us not love with words or tongue, but with action and truth.
And in truth. Come
my
on now.
God,
oh, my God. That's why.
Word.
That's why we got to be careful what we attach ourselves to.
That's right.
You know, and when we look around, we see the world is, you know, looking for love. There was a lot of things, Pastor, that happened in 2020.
Yes.
Oh my God. And I really believe a lot of this was designed. I'm gonna say this here.
Right.
To divide the kingdom, to divide the people of God.
Amen.
We allowed things that were said on the media. We allowed, and I'm not condoning what happened, but we should have came together as a body. No, we may not agree all the time. Amen. Peter and Paul didn't agree. They argued and they fussed and they disagreed, but they did not allow their disagreements to stop them from fulfilling the kingdom call that was on our life. Come on, Pastor.
We have an opportunity right now to minister to hurting, pain-filled world.
Yes, yes.
It's our time.
It's our time. It's our time.
Amen. We cannot deny injustice and stay quiet.
Uh-huh.
We have to be more than not racist. We have to be anti-racist.
That's right.
Amen.
Oh, my God. Amen.
Amen.
All right. I like that. You said we have to be more than not racist. We have to be anti-racist. And when you serve Christ Jesus, you can.
That's right.
You can. There were a lot of things that happened that hurt the believers during 2020. Amen. But now we have to come together.
Yes.
We have to come together and reconcile.
That's right.
And because there's still a hurting world out there.
Yes,
a lot of people turned their back on Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Because they did not understand. I'm going to be real with you. There were times when I woke up, I said, God, what is going on? What's happening, Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. But because of my love for Christ.
Yes.
Amen. Because I knew he loved me. I trusted him. And that is why we got to come together and love one another and reconcile our differences.
That's
through
right.
The word, through the gospel.
Amen.
I'm not saying compromise. No, we are not supposed to compromise when it comes to the word. But we are supposed to exhibit the word
exhibit.
Through the love that That's Christ right. taught us. Listen.
Amen.
To be anti-racist means that you are aware and striving to find a solution for the problem.
Mm.
That's what we should be. We understand that there may be racism out there. We understand that a lot of things, and that's why we did those three-part series,
mm-hmm.
amen, weeks ago, because we wanted the people of God to understand what was happening
That's right.
in this season. What are we fighting against? We're not fighting against flesh and blood.
That's right.
I'm not fighting against, amen, Kingdom Revival Church. I'm fighting against a demon
mm-hmm.
that's trying to keep us, amen, from coming together.
That's
because
right.
when we come together, the word of God says where there's unity,
yes.
my God, Pastor, there is strength. Listen, to be anti-racist means that you are aware and striving to find a solution for the problem.
Amen.
Amen. And it is found in you. You will ask God to remove and make it right. So in other words, if there's something in your heart that's not right, you have to first ask God, God, remove the bitterness out my heart.
That's
remove
right.
the anger out my heart.
Yes.
Because in this next season,
yes.
oh my God, in this next season of the glory,
come on now.
Oh, in the next season of the revival,
uh-huh.
I want to be used by God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh my God, my God. Listen. Proverbs 31:8-9 say, speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves, for the rights of all who are destitute. Speak up and judge fairly.
That's right.
My God, defend the rights of the poor Amen. And the needy. All right. The scripture here says that if our hearts do not condemn us, my God, we have to learn how to speak up. We got to speak up for what is right.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Because there's a lot of people, they can't speak up for what's right.
That's right.
But we, when we came to Christ, he changed our hearts.
Yes.
He changed our way of thinking.
Amen.
Oh my God, used to sell drugs out on the street, mm-hmm. but God changed your way.
Thank you, Jesus.
And because he changed your way, Pastor, mm-hmm. you can speak up and let the others know
That's right.
that Christ is a healer.
Yes, he
He's
is.
A deliverer.
Amen.
Oh my God, I got to keep it moving. The scripture here says, if our hearts are right with God, then we are told that we will have right relationship with God.
Amen.
If our hearts are right, I can speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves.
Thank you,
Jesus. Oh my God, because guess what? God changed my way of thinking.
Yes,
he changed my way of believing.
Yeah.
Oh my God. And because he did that, we are called to the ministry of reconciliation.
Amen.
Well, I want to bring something to your attention. God says, amen, in the book of Luke, and I don't have time to read it all. We are to be loving each other in the body of Christ.
Yes.
Amen. And we are to love those that need to experience the love of Christ, who are crying out and hurting for someone to tell them that there is hope in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
There is a dying world out there.
Yes.
My God, the prostitute that's on the corner,
mm-hmm.
that's selling her body. Oh my God, because she feel like that's the only way that she can survive. I believe there's a prostitute that God has saved and God has delivered and God has brought you out. Don't you be ashamed of your testimony.
Amen.
You can share that
share
testimony.
That,
you know, a lot of times, amen, on riding down Phillips Highway sometimes, amen, you can see them walking.
Mm-hmm.
And we got to get bold enough to stop
yes.
and tell them, look, Jesus loves you.
Yes, he does.
There is a way out.
Yes, it is.
Oh, my God. And I believe this is why God is calling us to be more kingdom-minded. I believe this is why in this season that, Pastor, that God is blessing the kingdom so that we could be a blessing to others. Look at this. Look at this. I know I got away a little bit, but that's the Holy Ghost. We are to love those that need to experience the love of Christ. No matter where they are at, we got to love them. Amen. They are not too far from the outstretched hand of Jesus. In other words, they are not too far
Amen.
From the outstretched hand of Jesus to yes. save them
yes.
and to restore that relationship with them. Yes. All right. So what are we talking about? Restoration.
Amen.
We're talking about the love of the brethren.
Love of the brethren.
The love of the brethren. Come on, Pastor. We got a few minutes. Come on.
Praise God. When I think about this situation, I think about the pain that people are going through inside the house of God. Not so forth in love, not so forth in kindness, but just seeing tradition and everyday religion.
Mm-hmm.
And what this have done is turn the people of God into robots
mm-hmm.
instead of showing forth true love.
Mm-hmm.
Once you break that barrier, once you come out of your comfort zone and just start flowing love and showing forth love, what it does is it attaches on and it starts a love barrier inside the house of God. And
yes.
one person began to show forth that person love, and that person began to show forth that person love, and it becomes real.
Yes.
And once we stop showing forth this love, we have to continue on in the body of Christ.
My God, my God. That's powerful. This world needs Jesus in
yes,
our closing. The pain and the hurt and uncertainty of this life
yes.
has got to be healed by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And God uses us. Amen. We have to bridge the gap and be willing to love like Jesus.
Amen.
This child was willing to help my grandbaby come down.
That's right.
It didn't matter. She wasn't concerned about COVID. She didn't ask, do you have on a mask? She just helped her come down. I am Apostle Dr. Barbara Patterson, along with my husband, co-pastor, Lorenzo Patterson, and we are excited that you have joined us. We thank God for Bishop Jackson and the Inspired Network. We love you.
Hello, Pastor. I'm Dr. Jackson. Have you been wanting to do television? Maybe you have been looking at some of the pastors in our city, watching them preach and reach thousands of people in the world. But you've said it's been too difficult or you can't afford it. I want to give you an opportunity. I'm opening a window for 10 pastors and 10 ministries to sign up. I'm offering a special offer to pastors to sign up. I need 10 pastors and 10 leaders to sign up. I want you to call me today and I'm going to put you on our television network. We reach over 250,000 homes a day and I want to help you reach thousands on social media. Learn the science that make things happen with the Inspired Network. Hi, Pastor. I'm Bishop Jackson. I'm a local pastor in Jacksonville, and I get excited about media ministry. You say, why? Because that's my calling. Some are called for one thing, some are called to another. But media ministry is where my calling is. That's my lane. I want to help you do media ministry, and I want to help you do it well. I want to help you improve your social media, your streaming, your video editing, your sound, your lighting, the production, building the set for your church. Could you imagine your people in your church could do it? Not hotshot people that you got to send away to be trained. I can train them in our virtual media camp. For 3 days, I'm going to be training church leaders from around the world. I want you to plug in for a 3-day virtual training. Go to www.virtualmedia.today.
Are you a leader frustrated over the media ministry? Are you one that works the media ministry but don't have the tools to be the best you would like to be? Have you been struggling with the idea of getting trained? Maybe you have thought about even going to a major conference far away, but you can't get away. Well, there's finally a conference for people in media ministry that are willing to be trained with the experts in their field. You can learn how to take your media ministry to the next level. Learn and get trained how to do it all, from stage lightning to live streaming and podcasting. You can get the training live and ask questions. Now, if you miss something, you go back and watch it on demand at no additional cost. All participants will receive a certificate. Sign up today for this virtual conference at www.virtualmedia.today.